And joining us via Skype is legal practitioner Monde Ubani. Thank you, Barrister Monde Ubani, for joining us on the news.
Thank you for having me.
And how are you doing today?
I'm good, and you?
I'm great, thank you for asking. There have been calls from several quarters asking for transparency and accountability for the funds disbursed on COVID-19 palliative. Is this a justified call?
It's clearly a justified call, especially with palliatives that have not actually gotten to Nigerians that is meant for. You remember that there was this total lockdown, and people were not allowed to go out, and they were asked to stay at home in order to avoid the spread of the disease. And a lot of people listened to that instruction for a while. While they were at home, some donations were being made to the state government and to the federal. And up to now, most of them did not get those palliatives. You know, so questions started flying about what is going on, what has happened to those contributions that were made by so many Nigerian philanthropists. You know, how did government even utilize the money in the first place? Are they being judiciously utilized? And why are people not giving those palliatives? Of course, government at the time had to now unlock Nigerians and start ask them to go out. But meanwhile, that their lives are clearly now in their hands. And so there is nothing fundamentally wrong for people to ask for accountability. Implicit in leadership is actually accountability. So they should account for all those monies and things that were given by people to the government. There's nothing wrong with that.
Talking about how judiciously the government has been in the spending of the relief fund, President Muhammadu Buhari had announced that a sum of 10 billion naira grant has been given to Lagos State, being the epicenter of the virus, while 5 billion naira was allocated to the National Center for Disease Control. And the State Assembly now calling for an explanation of how funds for COVID-19 have been spent so far by Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu. Is it in their place to make such demand?
Whether it was wrong for them to make such a demand?
Is it in their place to make such demand?
Oh, yes. In fact, that has always been the responsibility assigned to the legislative arm of government. Issue of holding the executive accountable and issue of oversight function. Apart from issue of appropriation, oversight function is a very critical, important duty of the legislative arm of government. And so if monies have been actually given to Lagos State government, including the 10 billion you mentioned, and several other monies also given by private individuals to the state government, the state government owes that duty to the legislative arm of government to give a proper account, in fact, to Lagosians. We need to know how those monies were actually spent. And that is, as I said earlier, implicit in leadership anywhere in the world is issue of accountability. But here, in this part of the world, we have not been seeing it because our institutions are very weak. The legislative arm of government is a very important arm of government that the Constitution itself, first of all, created in Section 4 before it created the executive and even legislative arm, meaning that these are the people representing, they are the true representatives of the people. And so their duty is actually to ensure accountability in governance and ensure issue of oversight function and then do what the Constitution has assigned, issue of appropriation. But most times we've seen that most of those houses all over the Federation are very complacent. Most of them are just a toothless bulldog. They are being used by the executive most time to accomplish most of the things that have been happening with issue of corruption in Nigeria. And so you get happy and you get so excited if you see any arm of government like the legislative arm here in Lagos trying to do its constitutional duty by holding the executive accountable. To me, that is clearly, clearly something that is commendable. I'm very, very happy with what they have done so far. And I hope they mean it. The executive now should now properly account what has happened to the 10 billion that the federal government has given. What has happened to all the monies Lagos State government have actually gotten in regard to this? We also want a replica of that at the federal level. What has happened to all the budget, all the billions we hear that have been spent by the federal government with regard to palliatives? And we're not hearing, people are not, you know, saying that we are recipients of these palliatives. So I'm very happy with the Lagos State House of Assembly for holding and asking, you know, setting critical questions on the issue of accountability of all the money that Lagos State government has actually received.
Now, Barrister Ubani, in your assessment, would you say that the palliatives given to Nigerians have been commensurate with the monies to the tune of billions of naira donated by corporate bodies as well as notable individuals?
Well, we've been hearing billions having been spent, especially at the federal level, and then the Minister for Disaster, you know, Ministry has been, you know, reeling out figures, you know, of how billions have been spent on Nigerians. I am telling you that I have taken time to ask questions on my social media handle. I have asked, is there any person that anyone knows, even if I don't know any person, because I have asked, you know, from my village, they didn't receive anything from the federal government. From people that I know who are also poor of the poor in this country, in the Lagos where I stay, I have not received any person giving me a feedback that they have received anything from the federal government, either money or any in terms of food assistance. Now, I've also asked people, what, do you have your own relations? Let people relate with me whether they have received anything. And nobody has actually come up. And that's why you see people breaching the issue of sit-down, the lockdown measure that the federal government put in place. People were saying, look, you can't ask us to, you know, be locked down, and then you are not providing anything in terms of food, that the hunger virus was even more deadly than coronavirus. And that's why you see people breaching it to the extent that the government now had to now concede and they made up their mind and say, you're well, now your lives are in your hands. You can go out, but your lives are one now responsible for it. So what I'm trying to say is that the level of palliative that we have heard or people have actually disclosed, what they have received is not commensurate to the amount of money we keep on hearing that have been mentioned that the government has spent so far on palliative. Nobody that I know have actually come forward to say, I received either 1 naira or 2 naira. And even the measures we suggested to them to use in sharing these palliatives, like the BVN or using the INEC registered voters in order to reach out to every Nigerian, you know, that are, you know, poor, they didn't use all that method. They keep on telling us that they cannot in any way utilize all the methods people were suggesting. So I don't think that government have actually been truthful with Nigerians, and everyone knows it. Virtually 95% of Nigerians are actually, you know, not too happy with the federal government and state government in issue of palliative in the regard with regard to this pandemic, that everyone is actually a victim.
Interestingly, there are also others who say Nigerians are not being updated well enough as far as the money being spent and expenses around curbing the spread of COVID-19 is concerned. What are your thoughts on this also?
And that is actually the truth. Unless they are saying that they are suspending the issue of accountability until this stable time, they can account to all the monies that have been spent. But I think that our leaders have actually taken us for a ride because of the kind of people that we are. We are not, I don't know how to describe Nigerians. You know, we accept anything in terms of bad governance here in this part of the world. But it doesn't happen like that anywhere in the world. You cannot, you know, tell me that in this pandemic where we see what other nations are doing to their citizens, that Nigerian citizens can sit so quiet and allow their leaders to play, you know, a game, you know, over this pandemic. We are hearing the kind of amount of money these people are spending. We have seen the flurry of activities with regards to building up all these isolation centers, some of them, you know, not too, you know, strong enough, not too, you know, accommodating enough, you know, to warrant the kind of money that they will call later. And they're using this pandemic, and this is, I'm sounding alarmed to Nigerians. These leaders, our leaders, both at the state and federal level, may be using this pandemic now in order to amass so much wealth. And that is where I will expect Nigerians to be serious about accountability, that government must account to Nigerians. At the end of this pandemic, if they come up with figures that are so bogus, that is unrealistic with reality, that Nigerians should raise alarm and hold our leaders accountable, and then ensure that EFCC comes into this matter in order to investigate every strata of government that have actually claimed they have spent billions in handling this pandemic, because Nigerians have not felt anything. There is no responsibility that has actually been carried out by the federal or state government towards the people in the, apart from coming to tell us about the figures that are increasing by the day. We have not seen anything that have actually assuaged our feeling that government cares about us. And that concerns every strata. There is no government strata that is probably is exculpated in this blame. They have not shown us love. They have not shown us good governance. They have not shown us good leadership with regard to this palliative. And that's why most people are now risking their life in going out to look for their daily bread. And I just hope that we don't become victims like what we hear happen in America and in Italy, because the level of social distancing is not much, and they are not observing even those basic measures, you know, that have been put in place by the experts. They are not observing them because everyone for himself, all of us, to by being protected by God. They have left us now on our own. The government has not shown responsibility. And Nigerians must all gather together to ask for account when this pandemic is over.
Okay. Barrister Mondo Obani, it's been a pleasure having you join us on the news. And thank you for your contribution.
It is my pleasure, my brother.